that Chanakya was a great communicator. He went to different rajas, and told them, here is a big enemy called Alexander. And remember one thing, Chanakya was not a king. He did not have his own army. And he had to defeat a bigger army, an opponent. So he communicated to everybody. Some people agreed. Some people did not agree. In fact, one king called Dhananand, you saw him? He insulted him and he said, get out. And Dhananand was the most powerful king. He did not support Chanakya because what did he say? I am in Magad. Magad is in modern Bihar now. And the capital of Magad during those days was Pataliputra. Now it is Patna. Alexander was coming from Afghanistan. Remember that? And when Chanakya went and communicated a problem, Dhananand did not understand. He said, Mere Rajya ka problem thodi hai, wo to udhar ka Rajya ka problem hai. But Chanakya did not leave. He went to smaller kingdoms and many people joined him. You saw that? Shudrak and all those different kingdoms. So, very good point of communication. In life, if one friend doesn't support you, don't feel bad. Go to the next friend. Go to the next friend. All of you will have lot of ideas, isn't it? Mujhe ye karna hai, wo karna hai. Some friends don't like to support you. Ha! Faltu. It's a useless idea. And you'll start feeling bad. You'll start feeling depressed. Don't do that. Go to the next friend. Go to the next friend. And please have a friend circle in which you support each other's ideas and creativity. Remember that, okay? You know what Chanakya says? He wrote a book called Arthashastra, right? In that book he says, never fight a battle alone or never fight an enemy alone. Take your friend along. Kabhi bhi yuddh akele nahi karte. Doston ko saath mein leke jao. So if you have a problem, first is communication. Second way how to handle a problem or a challenge in life is have a friend circle with you. He did not want to save only his little kingdom. He wanted to save the whole country. By the way, which part of India are we currently? Which part of India? Are we in South India now? I think we are in South India. Which part of India are we in? North India. But North India mein kaun sa part? We are in which part? We are in Sonipat, right? Now tell me one thing. If there is a problem in Sonipat, if there is a problem, let's say there is some earthquake or maybe some riots or something like that. Do you know how that whole challenge of this particular place is managed? The first people who will come to manage the challenge, let's say there is a small earthquake, just imagine, or there is a riot. The first thing that will be taken care is by the local police. Isn't it? The policeman will come and then he will handle it. But sometimes the problem is so big that the police will inform the police station and a bigger police team will come, isn't it? If one hawaldar, one constable cannot handle that problem, then what he will do? He will call a group of policemen. Sometimes what happens, the problem is so big that they will call police from other parts. Have you known that police has something called as reserve police also? You should study the administration. So they can get thousands of policemen. Now think about it that if your police department is not able to solve the problem, do you know what they do? They call the army. And they will not tell, you know, abhi hamare North India mein we have a problem, therefore South Indian army will not come. Do they still like that? So very beautiful point. Chanakya was looking at the problem of a nation, not of a kingdom. Aur ek baat aapko batata hu. There is two concepts. One is called Rajya and one is called Rashtra. Okay, remember these two words. One is called Rajya. Main Raja hu, isn't it? Aur Rajya is a kingdom, a small kingdom. During Chanakya's time, there were 16 regional kingdoms, but they are different from each other. Like we have many states in India, right? We have Maharashtra, we have Punjab, we have Haryana, we have West Bengal, we have Jammu and Kashmir. But those are states, and each of the states is led by a chief minister and a governor, isn't it? Governor is the first head of the state, supported by a chief minister. Like in India, at the top level, we have the president and the prime minister, isn't it? So when there is a problem, you cannot tell it's a North Indian problem. It's a national problem, isn't it true? So Chanakya understood it, that Alexander is coming to defeat Punjab. He was not coming to Magad. But Chanakya went all over India and he said, listen, all of you are thinking like Rajya. All of you should be thinking like Rashtra. Do we ever take saying that, you know, I am committed to North India? We are not a North Indian citizen, we are an Indian citizen, isn't it true? Remember, all of us, whichever part of India we may come from, when you go abroad, you will have an Indian passport, isn't it true? The color of the Indian passport is blue, navy blue, okay? Outside India, nobody recognizes you, like, you know, North Indian passport will have yellow color because it's a nice color, you know, yellow, nice color. We all have to understand that Chanakya realized all of us want to fight for our little place. He was the first person who introduced the concept of a nation. Nation is always bigger than a kingdom. Rajya se rashtra bada hota hai. This story of Chanakya is 2400 years ago. 2400 saal pehle, 4th century BC mein hui thi. Modern day mein bhi ye hua hai. Do you know when Britishers were ruling India, how many kingdoms we had? 550 princely states. You remember that? Chote chote raja, rajgharane the. And there is one person who took the lead and united everything into one nation. Britishers never created a nation. Britishers were ruling 550 princely states called as India. And who was that person who united India? Sardar Vallabhbhai. So when Britishers were leaving India, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel's biggest challenge was to make all the Rajas think like a Rashtra. You remember that? And Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel went, all of his study history, and they made them united into one country called India. The department made India into states. But remember, that is an administrative model. But we are one nation. The same Indian army will go to Jharkhand and the Himalayas when there is a landslide, isn't it? And the same Indian army will go to South India or to North India or East India or West India, depending on the problem. And the army never says, ki, I am from Maharashtra. Even though there is a Maharashtra battalion, there is a Rajput, isn't it? Anybody has got relatives, family, friends in the army? Uncles, aunts, they're very, very proud. They say, I am from Rajput regiment. Have you seen that? I am from this regiment. I am from Maratha regiment. I am from this regiment. But what is very important is that they always say one common word. It is called Jai Hind. So Rajput regiment is a different unit of the same Indian army. So when you have an outside enemy, don't think like Rajya, think like Rashtra. And that's the life lesson, that never ever ever make yourself think like a small state, one unit from one community. No, hamare se bada rashtra hota hai. Clear? Yes. When you do your PhD, it's called Viva OC, it's a presentation. So there'll be scholars sitting, teachers sitting and asking you questions. It happens, right? So you're doing a presentation. So the real scholars were asking the young teenage boys sitting over there different questions, and they were answering. So one of the questions they asked is that what makes you a great leader in a different way. So he was answering different questions. So one of the questions he asked was, sabse bada shatru kaun? Sabse bada shatru kaun sa? Ahanka, ego. I'm number one. Other person is useless. Sabse bada shatru, the biggest enemy is not outside, the biggest enemy is inside, etc., etc. But what happens is that students sometimes get afraid of very powerful people. So there is this particular king called Dhananand, the bad king, you remember? And he insults him. And Chanakya, the teacher, was sitting there quietly listening. And he said, the king doesn't respect knowledge, so I better go away. Socha tha, Patliputra mein aake, I will listen to some philosophical discussions and the king should appreciate. You know, in the olden days, the kings were also wise people and they liked to connect with other wise people. And then he left. But Dhananand insulted him and he said, you think I'm an ordinary teacher? I will show you that the teacher is bigger than the king. Main apne students log ka nirman kar lunga. And then he comes out, and the last scene, he chooses one student. What is his name? Chandragupta. And the last discussion, he says to Chandragupta, kal se tumhara dvitiya janam hoga Chandragupta. That means tomorrow morning onwards, I will teach you Rajavidya. I will teach you what? And I will give all my knowledge to you, and finally one day you will replace Dhananand. And that is what happened. So remember one thing, teachers are not ordinary, and if you get a great teacher, he or she, learn from them, okay? And you will become successful in life. I want all of you to understand one thing. Today, if you look at our age group, it's all teenagers. But remember, second life lesson. First is about unity, about friends. The second life lesson is about teachers. Teachers will come to you in different phases of your life, in different forms. I told you, mother is also a teacher, father is also a teacher, teacher in schools and colleges, guests are also teacher. But remember one thing, when you go out of schools and colleges, you will find different teachers from different fields. For example, if somebody decides to start their business, isn't it? Don't think that, you know, by doing some course you will become a businessman or a businesswoman. You will require a business guru, isn't it? That person will teach you. Somebody wants to become a sports person, isn't it? So that sports person will require a sports coach. Somebody wants to go into maybe animation industry or develop a technology company. You think you can do it alone? No, you require a guru. And remember, never ever 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 disrespect any guru, even if he's not your guru. For example, if you want to be a sports person, you have a sports guru, but your friend wants to become a businesswoman. She has got a business guru. Now, your guru is a sports guru. Your friend's guru is a business guru, right? You should respect that person also. He may not or she may not be your direct teacher. So let me ask you, in schools, you have your own class teachers, you have various teachers, and there will be some teachers who will not be teaching you, isn't it? They may be teaching higher standards or they may be in a different division. But do you also respect the other teacher? No, wo mera teacher nahi. Do you ever compare? My teacher is better than your teacher. Never do that. Okay, never do that, because teachers cannot be compared. They have different style of teaching. They have different style of presentations. Remember, this thing you should also apply with your first teacher, your mother. Lot of people say that this is my mother, right? But the other person is also mother of somebody else, isn't it? And somebody else is the mother of somebody else. So you should respect your mother, but you should also respect motherhood in all mothers. Meri mummy teri mummy se achhi hai. That cannot be done. My teacher is better than your teacher. That cannot be done. Yes, your love to your mother will always be unique because you can't replace your mother, isn't it? But what is important, at least respect that she is also a mother of somebody else. Clear? So motherhood should be respected along with your own mother. In the same way, all teachers should be respected. If you don't respect all teachers, it is not good. Of course, you should actually respect your teacher directly, but other teachers in other schools, in other places of life. And I want to tell you a secret. You know, I have written many books and I've been very popularly traveling across the globe. So when I go to a different country, different university, I may go for 2 days. But you know what? I go and respect all teachers in that university and they get very surprised. Are you are not my student? Well, yes, I am not your student, but I want to be a learner from you. So if you are a sports person, you can learn from a business guru also. Maybe tomorrow you will start a sports management company. So second lesson, never ever disrespect a teacher. And secondly, respect your teacher along with all teachers of all fields. Clear? Chandragupta Maurya was a student, but Chanakya had many students in his class. He was a great teacher. What happened is that when Dhananand insulted him and Alexander was coming into India, Chanakya made an idea, a strategy. He made an army of his own students. अभी हर जगह जाके आर्मी को बोले ना, ओ राजा गिव योर आर्मी, ओ राजा गिव योर आर्मी, यूनाइटेड वी फाइट अगेंस्ट अलेक्जेंडर. बट चाणक्य क्रिएटेड एन आर्मी ऑफ हिज ओन स्टूडेंट्स एंड दे वर ऑल टीनेजर्स ऑफ योर एज. बट आई वांट टू टेल यू दैट चाणक्य वाज अ स्मार्ट टीचर. ही न्यू दैट टीनेजर्स मे टेक अप एन आइडिया बट दे विल नॉट स्टिक टू दैट आइडिया. यू नो व्हाट ही डिड? I am going to show you how Chanakya worked with the students along with the family of that student. Do you listen to your teachers or do you listen to your parents? Whom do you listen to more? Some people say, you know, mothers tell me this. Humse jo nahi bola jata, agar teacher bol de to aap sun lete, isn't it? And the reverse is also true. जो टीचर नहीं कर सकता वो मां कर सकती है, जो मां नहीं कर सकती वो टीचर कर सकता है. Now the thing is that when the student, a teenager was trained, Chanakya trained himself as a teacher, but he also took the help of the mothers to train the children. What is the discussion between Chanakya and that student's mother? There's a teenager boy, you saw him? Did you see that teenager boy? Uski mummy thi. And Chanakya had gone to the house of that student and he was speaking to the mummy. Do you know there is something called as PTA, Parent Teachers Association? Are you aware of this? Your parents come here, right? But in the olden days, parents used to also go to the house of the students. It is not only parents come here. I have students, I go to their houses also. And I'm telling you, when teacher comes to a house, everybody respects the teacher, right? Suppose your class teacher comes to your house, what will you do? Sab theek taak rakhenge. Your mommy will make the best of the food, isn't it true? You'll arrange everything. So, Chanakya visited this young boy and let me tell you, he was not Chandragupta Maurya. Chanakya worked with each of the students with love, care and respect. So the situation is, Alexander had come and the Greeks Alexander was a Greek, right? In Sanskrit language or during those days, it was called Yavan. So the Greeks were invading India and Chanakya was going to all the different kings. But he said, no, let me create an army of my own students. Of course, Chandragupta Maurya is there. But an army is not about one commander, it's about the whole troop, isn't it? He went to each of the students' house and made sure that he convinced the mother so that the mother will send the son to the army. You know, there's a saying, everybody wants to be a fighter, but nobody wants the son to join the army. Mera beta mar gaya to. It's only in certain Kshatriya community you will find mother is very proud. Chal beta ga. And you know what? Chanakya actually convinced the mother so that the mother is also understanding that your son is going for a higher purpose. Isn't it true? So Chanakya tries this emotionally. You tried for chocolate. And she tried it. And Chanakya tried it for the nation. So kya boli? Tu kaisi maa hai? Tu kaisi maa hai? That agar tujh pe koi war kare, somebody attacks you, and your son keeps looking at you, do you think you will be happy? Beta samne hai aur koi maa ko attack karta hai. Is it a good scene? So your son wants to join the army to actually beat Alexander, isn't it true? And you are telling him no. Then she feels, you know, chocolate. Main achhi maa nahi hu, main bahut achhi maa hu. So ja to use le ja. And remember, the son wants to join the army. वो मम्मी से झगड़ा करता है ना, माँ मुझे जाना है, तो चुप कर, अंदर जा, you get out, you don't know what it is. Mummies are very possessive, you know, about their kids. But last में, when she gets emotional, हाँ हाँ, okay, तो ले जा. And Chanakya gives a very dirty smile and says, तू ना बोलती तो भी मैं उसे ले जाता, isn't it true? He is already convinced. ना बोलती तो भी मैं उसे ले जाता, but I want your blessings, I want your support, I don't want him to be a runaway from the house. You understand this, my dear friends? Whatever you do in your house, please, please, please understand, the first thing is to take blessings. You may do a lot of things in your house. The house is where we belong to, right? We sleep there, eat there, we have fun, we have our rooms. But how many of you take daily blessings of your parents and grandparents? Raise your hands, look at the crowd. For all the others, I want you to do one activity. Achha, by the way, how many of you have grandparents in your houses? Good. Some of you are lucky and some of you are not. How many of you have grandparents still alive who may not be staying with you? They may be staying in a different place. Okay. From now onwards, we promise yourself, huh? Don't promise me. Every day, if your parents and grand, and especially your grandparents are with you, morning when you get up, before you go to school or wherever, before you go out of your house, okay? It could be school, it could be sports, it could be anywhere. First thing is that take the blessings of your parents and grandparents. And for those people who don't have grandparents, every day once speak to them on the phone. Because the grandparents may be away, but you still require their blessings. Will you do that? So, subah utke, when you get ready, just take the blessings. Go and take the blessings of the God and then only move the house. Even if your grandparents are not there with you, speak to them at least once in a day. 5 minutes. Will you do that? Okay. Now, Chanakya says that he may come with me, but there is a problem. What is the problem? You know, teenagers, and when I was a teenager, I also did that. हम लोग जोश में कुछ शुरू कर देते हैं और वो फेल हो गया तो वापिस आ जाते हैं, isn't it? I tried, but what to do? So this young boy wanted to join the army of Chanakya. Remember? He was creating an army led by Chandragupta Maurya. But what was interesting is Chanakya realized that युद्ध में जाने के लिए जोश बहुत है, जब युद्ध के मैदान में लोग भाग जाते हैं उसको बोलते हैं रणछोड़। यू नो वी हैव भगवत गीता, अर्जुना द ग्रेटेस्ट वॉरियर, द ग्रेट पर्सन वेंट टू द बैटल फील्ड एंड ही सॉ और बोला मैं नहीं आऊंगा, मैं जा रहा हूं। And then Krishna had to give the whole advice of Bhagavad Gita and tell him, my dear friend, you have to fight, you have to fight. In 18 chapters, 18 lectures he had to give him. Abhi ye apna student jata to hai, lekin bhaag gaya to, bhaag ke kidhar aayega? Ghar pe aayega na? And the mother will tell, kahan se aaya, bhaag ke aaya, kahan se? Ranbhumi se. Tu to bade josh mein gaya tha. You went in a josh saying that मैं झगड़ा करूंगा, लड़ाई करूंगा, भारत माता की जय, एंड तू भारत मान के आ गया, जा बेटा वापस जा। तो चाणक्य स्ट्रेटेजिकली क्या किया, फर्स्ट ही इंस्पायर्ड द स्टूडेंट्स, इजंट इट, सो दे वांटेड टू जॉइन द आर्मी, बट ही मेड श्योर दैट वंस यू जॉइन द आर्मी दैट पर्सन शुड नॉट कम बैक होम। यू टेक द ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ योर पेरेंट्स, इफ यू टेक द ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ द पेरेंट्स, प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड व्हाटएवर यू डू that will become successful. My spiritual guru Swami Chinmayananda used to tell, there are three kinds of people in this world. One who never start doing anything, thinking about the problem. Are agar shuru karega to ye problem aayega, wo problem aayega, he never starts or she never starts. First category, never start because they think about the problem. Second are interesting people. They start with lot of enthusiasm, but when the problem comes, they go back. Pehla don't start, problem. Dusra start and the problem comes, they come back. But the third are the most successful people who start, face all the problems and finally succeed. So remember one thing, never ever get defeated when there are problems on the way. Remember your goal, okay? So I'm going to tell you a story of a mother, from like this mother, you know. There was a small village and an enemy kingdom attacked that village and it was in a border state. The enemy was on the other side and they used to keep attacking. One day what happened? The enemies came and the army people announced, we require more young boys to join the army because the enemy is coming and we need. So they started recruiting the teenage boys of that particular village. There was this lady who was a widow. Her husband had died and she had three sons. So like this son, the first son, he was discussing with his friends in school. And they said, you know, I am going to join the army. So he also decided to go and join the army. Dushman ke aage humko matrubhumi ki raksha karni hai. And small village, and poor little widow. You know what all the friends of that mother told her? Unko bataya, dekho, behen, hum aapko advice dete hain. Ye jada deshbhakti sab theek hai, but if your son goes, he may die in the war. Isn't it true? But the mother did not tell anything. The first person went, the first son went, he joined the army and in that war he died. So the dead body came back home and all the villagers were there. And then one lady told her, Bataya tha na, I warned you, don't send your son. She did not tell anything. She was crying, of course the son is gone. And looking at that elder son's body, the second son, bade bhaiya mar gaye na? Second son told, I want to join. I also want to go and fight. But the war is still going on. And all the ladies told the mother, Abhi to sun le, pati gaya bahut saal pehle. Beta gaya, abhi bhi uske samne laash padi. Abhi second ja raha hai, usko rok le. The mother did not tell anything. Second son also joined. He joined and 2 days time, he was also killed and his body was brought to the house. Again, the whole village gathered. She was nothing. And again, the village lady said, Bola tha na, pehla gaya, dusra gaya. And looking at that, the third boy said, Bade bhaiya gaye, nichle bhaiya gaye, my second brother is gone. I want to join the army. And the ladies could not control themselves. They stopped that son. The beta, budape mein tere ko maa ka sahara banna hai. Do bhaiya the, pitaji ke koi nahi hai. And the boy was so, you know, inspired and went, no, I want to go. I want to be like my brother. All those things. And they told that mother, listen, abhi to sun le. Last hope of your life. And that boy also joined. And in 2 days' time, he was killed and his body was bought. And when he saw the body, finally the mother started crying. She just broke and started crying. Till now she never cried. First son gaya, never cried. Second son gaya, never cried. Third son, she started crying. And all the lady friends came and told her, "Ab kya fayda? What is the point of crying now? You never listened to our advice. Now you are completely gone. First of all, you are a widow, no husband. First son, second son, third son, also brilliant. Such inspiring boys, one of them at least you should have kept. Why are you crying now after loss of 3 sons? You know what she answered? I am not crying because my sons have died. I am crying because I don't have a 4th son to send to the army. I don't have a 4th son. I wish I had few more sons. Matrubhumi pe attack kiya hai, mera beta, 3 humne diya. Lekin problem to solve nahi hua na, dushman to abhi bhi aa raha hai, yudh to abhi bhi chal raha hai. Of course, finally that whole war got over. And what happened to this lady, you know? The lady was taken care by the whole village. Dekho, jab aap rashtra ke liye kaam karte ho na, so don't worry about your personal problems. Your personal problem will be taken by the society. For example, in the army, even today, there is called as Army Wives Association. Are you aware of this? So there is a husband who is in the army. So the wives have a small association and they know that their husbands are trained to die. Because when you join an army, and if a husband dies, the woman take care about themselves. My dear friends, remember, never be afraid of death, especially when it is coming to the nation. And Chanakya was the person who created lot of students who joined the army and fought for the nation. So third life skill, third important lesson of Chanakya for life is, your country is bigger than you and your family. Desh se bada kuch nahi hota. Desh se bada kuch nahi hota. So Chanakya is teaching us patriotism. And let me tell you friends, you don't have to join the army and die in that battlefield to show your patriotism. Sometimes you represent a country in a sports event, isn't it? For example, we have an Olympics contingent that goes from our country to represent in an Olympic game, Commonwealth, Asian games, right? Different. You may be a badminton player, you may be a tennis player, whatever your game. Remember one thing, when you step out of that particular country, your own country, then you are representing your country at the global level, isn't it? So let's say somebody is in the cricket team. So he is representing India in that cricket team, isn't it true? So whatever field, so some of you may be architect in the future, some of you may be sportsman, businessman, whatever, artist. But when you come back, they should say, you represent the country, desh ke liye kaam kiya. Okay? I have realized one thing, that all of you are lucky because you know Chanakya and Arthashastra at your age. When I was in school and college at your age, I did not know about Chanakya. And I realized one thing. Chanakya was a teacher, remember that? And he trained children how to defeat any big challenge, be it Himalaya or any other problem. And you know what is that particular thing which he taught the students? How to face and overcome any challenge? Listen carefully. It is called the knowledge of Anvikshiki. How many of you heard about this word? First time, no? I'll repeat it again. the knowledge of anvikshiki. Can you repeat after me? Anvikshiki. 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 If you want to write, you can write it down. In the book also it is there. Now I tell you what is anvikshiki. It is a combination of two Sanskrit words. It is called anu and ikshiki. You know what is anu means? Atom. Atom is the smallest particle. You must have learned, right? So, atom and ikshiki means the one who is searching. Who is searching for a solution. Many times when we have a problem, we think about the problem rather than thinking about the solution. Isn't it true? So I tell you, anvikshiki is a subject that Chanakya taught students as the first subject in their schools. You know what do we learn as the first subject in school? Alphabets and letters, isn't it? A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3, ka, kha, ga. It is okay. But Chanakya says, children should be first taught how to think and solve problems. Thinking as a subject, and that subject is called anvikshiki. I will give you an example. All of you go to doctors, correct? And there are different types of doctors, right? There is a general physician, there is a dentist, etc., right? Now tell me one thing. Why is the doctor a doctor? Why is the doctor, we call him or her as a doctor? He's qualified, isn't it true? They've studied the medical science, isn't it? I can't call myself a doctor. Why? Because I've not studied medicine. A person who has studied a subject is an expert in that subject. But do you know, apart from the knowledge of the medicine, he also knows one special skill. It is anvikshiki. He may not know it. She may not know it. It is called the process of diagnosis. You know what is the meaning of diagnosis? Samajhna ki problem hai. For example, aapka ped dukh raha hai. That's a problem. You go to a doctor. You have faith that he's a good doctor. He's a qualified doctor. Or she knows how to solve the problem. You know what will happen when you go to the doctor? The doctor will not give you medicine. The doctor will first diagnose the problem. Isn't it true? He or she will tell, okay beta, she will ask you certain questions which is called symptoms. Isn't it? So you will say, doctor ji, ped dukh raha hai. And the doctor, with her or her medical learning and skill, knows ped dukh raha hai and this ped has got various parts. Isn't it? Hamare liye ped dukh raha hai. But doctor says there is large intestine, small intestine, there's a liver, there's a kidney, isn't it true? So what he says, okay beta, kuch kar, ulta seedha khaya tha kya, isn't it? When did you have some food? How is it troubling you? And then he or she will first touch the place, isn't it? Okay, then he'll come closer. Oh, achha, don't worry, he will tell the mama, don't worry. It's a normal problem. I think it's some gadabad food, some fast food he has eaten. Theek ho jayega, still give some. But sometimes what happens, the doctor says, oh, it is not a regular thing. I need to think deeper. And then they will tell your mother or father and say, iska x-ray kara ke leke aao. Isn't it true? So you do the x-ray. And then they say, oh, there is this problem. Like I remember one of my friends going and said, oh, my friend, now my, isko kidney stone hai. Kya hai? So it's a pain, not because of eating a wrong food. It is not food poisoning. It is because there is a kidney stone. So the medicine the doctor will give you for a kidney stone is very different when the doctor gives you medicine for loose motions or maybe for something like a gas infection or food poisoning. So for you, The problem is पेट दुख रहा है, isn't it true? But the doctor does something called as investigation, isn't it true? And once you find out the problem, you can easily solve it. Are you clear? This process of thinking about any particular problem is actually called anvikshiki. I want all of you, whenever there is a challenge that comes, never get carried away by that problem, but socho. Ye kyu problem hai? What is the problem? Why is the problem? And I tell you, once you understand the problem in detail, you will get the solution also. For example, you may be seeing this with your friends. Your own best friend, some days is very irritated and troubled. Have you seen that? Seedha baat nahi karenge. They'll do tantrums. Then don't get. One time say, hey, aaj tune mere se achha baat nahi kiya. You are my best friend, but you're not speaking to me properly. You should think, my friend, my best friend for so many years, never does like this, isn't it? Today there is something different in her. So don't start blaming her and saying that you didn't wish me happy birthday today. You forgot my birthday today. That is natural. But if you apply anvikshiki, you will start thinking, my best friend who always remembers my birthday, today doesn't even remember my birthday. And not only that, she's not even looking at me. And you will feel bad. Forgot my birthday, wait. And then why is she like this? Then, pyar se, you start diagnosing the problem like a doctor, isn't it? Achha. I think even during research time, she's not eating the food also. And you know, offer her. Why don't you take a little bit from my tiffin box? No, I don't want it. Oh, she's so troubled. She's a foodie girl. She always gets gift for me. She always gets food for me. She's not even bought her food. And she's not even taking my food. That's a problem, right? And slowly, you start diagnosing. And then you realize what she's expressing is only a troubled mind. Isn't it true? And then you find out actually uske ghar pe uske mummy ya badi didi ke saath jhagda hua. Isn't it true? Then he said, oh, okay, simple thing. She's not in a good mood today, right? So you diagnose the problem, and by evening when she's a little bit normal, you know, and then you say, abhi, are you did not have your breakfast, you didn't have your lunch, now let's go out today. And then she'll be okay. So sometimes some problems are simple. But sometimes when you diagnose it, you realize, oh my goodness, I know of a case, and it's a real case. A girl came to school and she was very troubled. And the teachers were trying to find out, but she was now very quiet sitting. And in the evening they realized actually her grandfather had died. But what happened is that because the parents did not want the child to be at home on that day, they sent her to school. So the parents said, theek hai, now grandfather has died, and she was very close to the grandfather, right? And there are some relatives expected to come from different parts. So unhone kya bola, abhi ye bechari dekhegi. So what they did is that they did not tell her. In the night, the grandfather had expired. So she in the morning realized that there is something abnormal in my house. Everybody is going to that room and I am not allowed in that room. And they are saying, "Nena, beta, abhi tum na tayar hoke school chale jao." My mother actually packed everything and made me go. She did not allow. So she could sense that there is something wrong. And then somewhere in the back of the mind, she realized that there is something wrong with grandfather and there are so many people in the house. Have you ever come across such situations? And that time you realize if you have a friend who is coming from that troubled state of mind, please understand the problem is not going to get solved by evening. Sometimes when you lose a very near and dear ones, you'd be surprised. Psychologists, child psychologists have told, sometimes it takes 25 years to come out of that problem. Do you know this? So when somebody is troubled and that girl has forgotten your birthday, don't start thinking about yourself. Think about that problem. They say if somebody who is very near and dear to you is lost, it takes minimum 2 years to come out of that problem. Do you know this? 25 years is extreme. was a very near and dear person. And remember one thing, grandparents and grandchildren are always close to each other, isn't it? Why are the grandparents and the grandchildren close to each other? Because they have a common enemy in between. जो मम्मी पापा नहीं करते वो हम ग्रैंडपेरेंट्स से करा के देते हैं ना. चॉकलेट मम्मी नहीं देगी तो दादा दादी दे देंगे. इमेजिन लूसिंग योर दादा और दादी. दैट्स अ वेरी 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 डिफिकल्ट एक्सेप्टेंस. इज़न्ट इट ट्रू? सो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई वांट टू स्टॉप हियर बाय टेलिंग यू समथिंग दैट इफ यू सी प्रॉब्लम्स अराउंड, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रॉब्लम, थिंक अबाउट द प्रॉब्लम एंड डोंट ऐड टू द प्रॉब्लम, रादर सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम. If your friend is troubled, don't trouble him or her more. आप समझ रहे हैं? अगर कोई troubled है, तो उसको और परेशान मत करो, उसको और प्यार से समझो. Because that friend needs you, isn't it true? I'm reading a wonderful book. It is called Sapiens. Homo sapiens, the human beings. And the scientist has told that we human beings always have to live in groups. We need each other. We require our friends. We require our families. और आपको पता है? The scientists say the biggest punishment you can give to human beings, children, teenagers, even elders, is to isolate them. उनको एक रूम में बंद कर दो. It is the biggest torture, isn't it true? We require family and friends along with us. We cannot live alone. So if somebody is living alone and there is a trouble, please understand that person requires your help. So when people die, you see everybody coming together. Therefore, even in your class, if there is one student who has failed in the class, and suppose you are number one in the class, I am number one that's failed. So you are very happy, right? And that one person doesn't know how to speak because he or she has failed in the class. What should be your attitude? Celebrate. Of course you should celebrate, but then go to the child, go to your friend and say, listen, I understand, but I will help you pass the exam next time. Therefore, you know, if your parents tell you, tumko room mein hum log alag rakh denge. Even if for criminals, you know, if somebody jo chori karte, government kya karte, prison mein dal dete, isn't it? They are isolated. Isolation is very bad. If there is somebody who is away from the group, please include him or her in the group. Slowly, don't force them. So we human beings, as somebody said, you know, Chanakya's greatest lesson was that we all should be united. We should never solve a problem alone. We should always solve a problem together. And how to think about the problem and solve the problem, that is called Anvikshiki. So friends, what is the final lesson, life lesson from Chanakya? Work for your country. राष्ट्र का निर्माण करना है. ओके, सो wherever you go, whatever you do, remember, we should be proud to be an Indian. And we should work on our Indian culture and promote it very proudly. But before that, study the Indian culture. And remember, I give you one example. Start with your family. Please spend your time with your family, especially with your grandparents. Every day, spend at least 1 hour with them. If they are not there with you, speak to them, and wherever you get an opportunity, please go and meet them or call them, and then you will understand and respect our culture and we'll be great people. Thank you so much.